Students, Sairam, welcome to your science class. You all know we are learning chapter number 12, part 4, electricity and circuits of your NCERT science textbook. I hope you all are following the concepts and understanding the activities which we are learning till now. Let's recall what we have learned in this chapter till now. An introduction, we learned the importance and various purposes of electricity. Then we have seen the design and the parts of electric cell and a torch bulb. Then we learned through an activity how a bulb is connected to an electric cell. And in previous class, online class, we understood what is an electric circuit and in what position of a circuit does the bulb glow. In today's class, we are going to learn about an electric switch. If you will observe this image, you will remember the circuit which we have explained you in previous class. We try to understand in the previous class where in this arrangement of torch bulb and the electric cell, if the base of the torch bulb touches the metal cap of an electric cell, it is in switch on position. And if we move away the tip of the metal tip of the bulb away from the metal cap of the electric cell, it is in switch off position, then bulb will not glow. But this kind of switch is not applicable to all electrical devices where we need to move electric device to the near and far to the electric cell. This is not possible. So because we have complex design of electrical appliances and the electrical devices, so we can design the circuit by providing a switch to do the on and off activity. Let's see how. Let's learn making an electric switch through an activity. For this, first let us see what are the requirements for the performing this activity. We require a drawing pins, the pins which we use to hold a chart paper and a paper on a board. And then we require a safety pin or a paper clip which is made up of some metal material. Two wires with bare ends, then small sheet of thermocol or wooden board for holding the switch, and of course a torch bulb we require to see whether the switch is working or not, and an electric cell to provide electricity. So these are the requirements required to perform this activity. In step 1, you will insert a drawing pin into the ring which is there at the one end of the safety pin. Then you will fix it on a wooden board or a thermocol board. As you can see in the image, children, you all know that at the one end of the pin there is a small coil or a ring like structure is there for the safety pin. Now next, children, what will you do for this? You will insert a drawing pin into that ring and you will fix it to a wooden board and a thermocol. And then what you are going to do, you are going to fix this tightly so that it cannot move out from the wooden board. While inserting the drawing pin on wooden board or a thermocol sheet, make sure that the safety pin can be rotated freely. Now next, to fix another drawing pin on the board or a thermocol such that the rotating safety pin can touch the other drawing pin also. You can see that in the given image which I have shown you on the screen, we will fix the other drawing pin near to the safety pin which is fixed to the wooden board or thermocol in such a way that the tip of the other end of the safety pin can touch the another drawing pin. Next is tie the two wires of pin before they are fixed to the board, wooden board or a thermocol. Then you can see in the image here or in the picture how it should be arranged. So this is the position of arrangement of safety pin and the drawing pins along with the wires which will act as a switch for the circuit. Now what you will do is you will make a circuit by connecting an electric cell and a torch bulb along with the two wires which are connected forms the switch. Here in the diagram you will see how we are going to do the arrangement to make a switch. So children, here we can conclude that when switch is on, that means the circuit is completed, and when the circuit is complete, then current will flow and the bulb will glow. And in case of when the switch is off, when switch is off means that the circuit is incomplete, there is a break in the circuit, and in that case, current will not flow through the circuit and the bulb will not go. In short, we can say that a switch is a simple device that either breaks the circuit or completes the circuit. The switch is used at our homes for lighting of electric bulbs and other devices. The same principle applies there too, but their design is different and complex to fit the circuit for your homes. What you will do is, one activity is there for you. Observe the image carefully. It is a homemade electric circuit with a switch. Try to build an electric circuit at your home under the proper guidance, with the proper help from any senior of your house, and under their guidance, try to build a circuit and electric circuit with the switch to understand the concept very well. Here there is an image shown for you to easily understand how an electric circuit is made along with the switch, and this should be the arrangement. A diagram also is given here if you observe properly. Children, so that is about electric switch. Now I have few questions to ask you. Why we are always asking you to remove the plastic covering of wires at their ends? Why are we always using the bare ends of the wire which we are using for connection to, and that to also stick to any electric cell or a touchable? Why are the complex switches and the switchboards at home are usually made of plastic? Can plastic conduct electricity? Then which substances are capable of conducting electricity? Now moving to the last topic of this chapter. In this topic we will study about electric conductors and insulators and how they are important in making electric circuit. And let's see first, what are conductors? Conductors, materials which allow electricity or electric current to pass through them, are known as conductors of electricity. Metals like silver, copper, aluminium, iron, gold, steel, etc. are the good conductors of electricity. Even few non-metals like graphite is also a good conductor of electricity. Even human body is also acts as a good conductor, and water is also a good conductor of electricity. So materials which allows electricity to pass through them are known as good conductors of electricity. And exactly opposite of these conductors are insulators. Materials which do not allow electricity or current to pass through them are known as insulators. And some insulators are rubber, plastic, wood, glass, cotton, jute. These are the examples of insulators which do not allow electricity to pass through them. To understand more about insulators and conductors, let's do one activity. If you will see in the image, we have made an electric circuit with the help of an electric cell, bulb and key. Anything will, if you will observe carefully, you will see that after attaching the key in the circuit, this given circuit is completed and the bulb is glowing. That means key is made up of a material which conducts electricity. That means this key allows electricity to pass through it, and that's why the key is known as, or key is an example of conductor, which allows electricity or current to flow through it, as it is made up of bulb. And as the electricity is passing through this key, this makes a complete circuit and bulb is glowing in this given circuit. Now next, children, here I have a question. Why bulb is not glowing in the this situation? Why bulb is not glowing in this situation? Because here one end of the cell and the other end of the base or tip of the bulb is attached to the plastic, and as we all know that plastics are insulators, so it will not allow electricity to pass through it. So in this situation, in this case, the bulb will not glow. Similarly, if you see here, in this case, both the ends here, the wire which is coming out of the cell and the other wire which is coming out of the metal tip, both the wires are attached to the, here if you see, here they are attached to the metal of the screwdriver. So in this case, the circuit is complete, hence that means electricity will flow, and because as the metals are good conductors, in this case the electricity will flow, hence the circuit is complete, then bulb will glow in this situation. Next, children, one question is there for you. The handles of the tools like screwdrivers and pliers used by the electricians for repair work usually have plastic or rubber covers on them. Can you explain me why? Because your children, electricians, generally they work the electronic appliances. That means they are handling the appliances which run on the electricity. And children, rubber and the plastic are bad conductors of electricity. They are insulators. They do not allow electricity or current to pass through them. Thus, they protect electrician from electric shocks while working or while repairing that electronic devices. So here, in this case, this the screwdriver which the electrician uses, it is covered with which is having a handle which is made up of plastic or rubber. Next, here one more question is there for you children. Just you have to tell me why the bulb will not glow in this arrangement. Yes children, if you will observe the given arrangement, you will find the one end of the bulb the tip of the bulb is here. It is attached to the plastic case of the screwdriver, and the other end of the wire which is coming out from the electric cell is attached to this metal of the screwdriver. But children, here the bulb is not glowing. Why the bulb is not glowing? As here one end is attached to the plastic, and plastic, as we all know, that it acts as an insulator. That means it will not allow the electricity to pass through that screwdriver, even though the one end is attached to the metal. So in this case, in this arrangement, bulb will not glow because here the circuit is not complete. Here the current which is coming out from the one end of the cell, it is reaching to the bulb, but when it is coming out of the bulb, it is not next forward, it is moving to the other end of the screwdriver, hence bulb is not glowing. Next children, one more question is there. Why do electricians wear rubber gloves while working? Yeah children, while working with the electricity, they need the protection from the electricity, and if they use rubber gloves which are insulators which acts as a barrier against the electric shock. So while working, if the electricians wear like these gloves, there will be no chance of getting electric shock. Next is children, even the electric appliances we have seen, mostly they are all made up of plastic body. Here plastic acts as an insulator. Insulators means the materials which do not allow electricity to pass through them. Here the plastic body acts as an insulator, and because of that we are not getting electric shocks as they are covered with a plastic body. Here children, we have seen that the metal the wires which through which electricity is passing, they are always covered with a plastic covering. Why the plastic covering is there on this copper wires? As we all know that copper wires, like these such wires, are used for the transportation of electricity from one place to another place. That means these wires carry electricity, and if we touch these bare wires, we are getting chance of getting electric shock. But if these wires are covered with an insulator, in this case plastic covering acts as an insulator which does not allow electricity to come out of this wire. And when if we'll touch this wire which is carrying electricity, but even it is having a plastic covering, we are not getting shock because of that. Children, here I am ending this session, even I am ending this chapter over here. Goodbye children.